السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين وأصحابه المكرمين المعظمين، أما بعد، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ومن يقتل مؤمنا متعمدا فجزاؤه جهنم خالدا فيها وغضب الله عليه ولعنه وأعد له عذابا عظيما. قال الله تبارك وتعالى في مقام آخر: من قتل نفسا بغير نفس أو فساد في الأرض فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. صدق الله العظيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد معدن الجود والكرم وآله الكرام وابنه الكريم وبارك وسلم. Respected brothers and sisters, we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of all the worlds, the most affectionate, the most gracious, the most merciful. We send peace, salutations, blessings upon His most beloved Nabi, our Nabi, last of the messengers, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. We send blessing upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's entire household, his Ahlul Bayt al-Tahar. We send blessings upon his all the companions, his Sahaba kiram. We send blessings upon every single one who have died in the state of Iman. On this blessed day of Jumu'ah, in this beautiful masjid, in this beautiful gathering, we make dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. We make dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us guidance, ease, and health in this dunya. We make dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant all of us jannah, maghfirah in hereafter. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen. My beloved Nabi, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam's beloved followers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِن تَجْتَنِبُوا كَبَائِرَ مَا تُنْهَوْنَ عَنْهُ نُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ وَنُدْخِلْكُمْ مُدْخَلًا كَرِيمًا. If you stay away from all types of major sins, kabair, major sins, نُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ, then I will erase all of your minor sins. وَنُدْخِلْكُمْ مُدْخَلًا كَرِيمًا, and I will grant you a beautiful place which is called Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to protect ourselves from major sins. كَبَائِر, gunahe kabira, major sins. And this is why we started a series called Major Sins a few weeks ago. Today, inshallah, we'll talk about the second major sin. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us, but I believe 99.99% of people, we do not commit this sin. Then I was thinking, should I talk about this or not, if we do not do this? But then I realized, no, I should talk. Because there are some circumstances where actually our mind can reach to that level. That's why it is better to have that information, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. And another point, we will know if Islam is so hard and it has a lot of punishment for this act, how come other people, they blame us about some particular act? And what is that? Today, inshallah, we'll talk about qatlun nafsi, killing someone. Murder. Murder, of course, as I said, majority of us, we do not kill someone. Inshallah, and in our life, we will not. We will not. Killing and second major sin. Second major sin. But as I said, if we do not do this, should we get information about this? Yes, we should know. We should try to get the best information, ahadith, ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we can protect ourselves and we can give guidance to others also, inshaAllah rahman. Let's talk about this ayah in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا. If you kill any Muslim brother or sister, mutaammidan, intentionally, purposely. It's not like you did not want to. When we drive sometime, we do, you know, face an accident. This is unintentionally. You do not want to kill someone. May Allah protect us from all kind of accidents and these things, inshallah. But when you face any kind of accident, road accident, or any other accident in a building or somewhere where something happens, you do not want to kill someone, but unintentionally someone get killed. So this is the different story. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا. When you kill someone intentionally, let's say you wanted to hurt someone with a rod or with a wood, you know, big wood, and you hit someone on a head, on his head. So still it is count as intentionally. Because you are doing something which can actually lead, you know that can lead one day or next day or sometime, it can lead to a major thing, major problem, which is killing someone. May Allah protect us. So Allah says, وَمَنْ يَقْتُلْ مُؤْمِنًا مُتَعَمِّدًا. If you kill someone, especially mu'min, فَجَزَاؤُهُ جَهَنَّمُ خَالِدًا فِيهَا. Look at the punishment. Allah says the punishment of that act is that person will be in Jahannam, خَالِدًا فِيهَا, forever. Forever. And second punishment, وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ, he will earn the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we do not have to be amongst maghzoob, those who earn the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why every salah, every rakat we do, make dua, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ. Oh Allah, do not give us hidayah to get on the path of those who have earned your anger. So we must stay away from any kind of action which can lead us towards the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the second punishment. وَغَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَلَعَنَهُ, and he gets the la'nat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Three major punishment. Major punishment. First one, Jahannam. I believe Jahannam itself is one of the biggest punishment. You do not need anything else. But still, there are so many people in Jahannam. Inshallah, one day they will finish their punishment and they will go to Jannah. Inshallah rahman. But ghadab and la'nat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is something major. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. Allah says, غَضِبَ اللَّهُ عَلِيهِ وَلَعَنَهُ وَأَعَدَّ لَهُ عَذَابًا عَظِيمًا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prepared a huge azab for them. Huge azab for them. Huge azab for them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect this entire ummah from such evil act. Why I'm saying for ummah, inshallah I'll come to that point, inshallah, after few ahadith. But it is something based on several things. People do fight, people do kill, people do hurt other people. Inshallah, I will talk about this. Let's move to the next ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this is the ayah, I would say all of you must remember it, memorize it. So you could let others know, this is the teaching of Islam. Pure teaching of Islam. The previous ayah was about mu'min. When you kill any believer, look what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about an ordinary people, those who are believer or not. Nafsan, anyone in the entire ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, man qatala nafsan bighayri nafsin aw fasadin fil ardi. When someone when anyone, especially a Muslim brother, when he kills another person, nafsan, another person, not Muslim, anyone, it could be Muslim, it could be disbeliever, it could be idol worshipper, it could be anyone, بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ unnecessarily, أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ, or someone create a cause a problem, fasad in this dunya, on this earth, فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا, it is as he has created entire humanity. As I said, please memorize this ayah. مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. If someone kills any person unnecessarily without any a valid point, فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا, he is as he has killed entire humanity. This is the pure teaching of Islam. This is the pure teaching of Islam. In today's world, people do blame on Islam about terrorism, about many other things, just because of those few ayahs which actually they do not know what is the Shani Nuzul. They do not know what was the era of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, why there was battles and everything. They do not know the background of those things. Some people, they do it purposely. Some people, they actually get trapped on social media, on the media platform, news and everywhere, where everyone lies about, stay away from facts. That's why people do think about Islam. Look at the teaching of Islam. مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ. Even in the battle, I'm telling you, when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to send sahaba for battle, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to give them guidance. Make sure you do not hurt anyone who is an older person and he does not have his arms to fight. Arms like sword and any kind of other weapon. If he is not carrying anything, you do not hurt. Make sure you do not hurt any kid. Make sure you do not kid anyone or any woman. Make sure anyone who does not carrying his arm, armors and his weapon, sword and anything, make sure you do not kill him. Rasulullah says, when you are in the battlefield, make sure you do not hurt any tree, especially if it is green. People are getting, benefits from it. If it is only shade, if it is fruits, anything, make sure you do not kill that. Look at the love, look at the, peace which Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is teaching to his sahaba. And now entire world, as especially, many news channels, many media channels, they always talk bad about Islam because they do not have correct information. This is the teaching of Islam. This is the teaching of Islam. مَنْ قَتَلَ نَفْسًا بِغَيْرِ نَفْسٍ أَوْ فَسَادٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ فَكَأَنَّمَا قَتَلَ النَّاسَ جَمِيعًا. Before I move forward, I would like to request those who are vaccinated or those who do not want distance, I would request them, please come forward in first and second row. We will not have distance in first and second row. So if you are vaccinated, alhamdulillah, several of us are, please come forward. Distancing will begin from the next rows. Jazakallahu khair. Now let's come to the point where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about qatl al-nafs. It's a major sin. It's a major sin. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also mentioned several ayah. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, it is, when you kill someone, it is as like you are committing a sin. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this is the narration of Sayyidina Muawiyah, قال سمعته يخطب ويقول سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, I've heard from Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, I've heard from Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, كل ذنب عسى الله أن يغفره إلا الرجل يقتل المؤمن متعمدا أو الرجل يموت كافرا. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم says, indeed Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He will forgive every single one. He will forgive every single one who have committed whatever sins he has done in this dunya. Besides, two kind of people. First one, the one who has killed any innocent Muslim brother. Anyone. If someone has killed another Muslim brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, Allah will not forgive. Or he he died as a disbeliever, kafir or mushrik. If he died as a disbeliever, kafir or mushrik, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forgive. We make dua, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us death on iman, inshallah rahman. We make dua for husnul khatima, inshallah rahman. If we get husnul khatima, inshallah we'll get jannah, inshallah rahman, inshallah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has commanded in several ahadith about these things, how important it is to stay away from such action which can lead us towards killing someone. But before that, I'm going to mention about the first murder ever in the history of humanity. You know that, right? Who did it? Qabil. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَاتْلُوا عَلَيْهِمْ نَبَأَ ابْنَيْ آدَمَ بِالْحَقِّ. Let's talk about two children, two sons of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. إِذْ قَرَّبَا قُرْبَانًا فَتُقُبِّلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمَا وَلَمْ يُتَقَبَّلْ مِنْ الْآخَرِ. Both of them, they had an argument about marrying a girl. And of course, Qabil didn't deserve to marry because he was a brother, actual brother of that girl. And Habil was deserving person to marry that girl. So Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam did not allow Qabil to get married. But still he fighted, he fought, he said, I want to. When Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam heard this, and he said, okay, let's do qurbani. Qurbani, let's present anything with good intention. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your, you know, presentation, your thing which you have presented, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts that, you are the winner, you deserve what you do. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not, then of course, the other person, he has right to get married to the girl. Both of them, if qarraba qurbanan, both of them, they did something. Qabil, he actually sorted animal. And Habil, he brought some, you know, grain, and he presented. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did, فَتُقُبِّلَ مِنْ أَحَدِهِمَا. Allah accepted from Habil. He did not, وَلَمْ يُتَقَبَّلْ مِنَ الْآخَرِ. And he did not accept from other one, from Qabil. Allah says, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts qurbani from those who are pious people, righteous people, those whose intention are good. And this goes for all ibadah, for all kind of worships. Whatever we do, we must do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with good intention. I've seen people, they do a lot of good deed, a lot of good deed with the intention of letting others know. I do not want to mention a name, but I've seen, you know, several people. It happens when they donate to the masjid, they give me, they say, Qari sahab, please do not say my name. Do not say my name, I do not want to that my name should be mentioned. You know, I do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why, you know, I've given this amount to Masjid al-Wali, but I did not tell anyone. I have donated this amount to this and that, but I didn't tell anyone. I did this, but I did not tell anyone. So make sure you don't tell also. I'm thinking, yes, you did not tell anyone. You didn't tell anyone. So these are the things. People do want to hide it just on, you know, their mouth. But they are the one themselves. They let everyone know. They let everyone know this is what we have done. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. Even if you tell others to encourage others, it is good. When we do fundraising, we do it openly. Several people, they do raise their hand. But this is also sunnah. And at the same time, this is to encourage others. But when you have not, we do not have good intention, you do it, you are doing it only with one purpose, with one intention, that people should notice, or you have any hidden something, hidden, you know, intention in your heart, Allah knows it. Innama yataqabbalu Allahu minal muttaqin. We are running away from topic, so let's come to the topic. Why did Qabil kill his own brother? Where the world just started. Sayyidina Adam was there, it was not like, you know, 2021. It was, world just started. At the very beginning, how come it became so easier for someone to kill his own brother? His own brother. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it's a beautiful narration, you know, you should read. Allah says, لَئِن بَسَتَّ إِلَيَّ يَدَكَ لِتَقْتُولَنِي مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِتَ. Where Qabil told Habil, I'll kill you. I will kill you. Habil says, even if you try to kill me, if you raise your hand to kill me, مَا أَنَا بِبَاسِتٍ, I will not do it. I will not do it. Quran says, it became so easier for Qabil to kill his own brother because of one reason. فَطَوَّعَتْ لَهُ نَفْسُهُ قَتْلَ أَخِيهِ فَقَتَلَهُ فَأَصْبَحَ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. It became so easier for his own brother to kill. It became so easier for Qabil to kill his own brother because of one thing. He made it easy because of grief, jealousy, anger, ghadab. It became easier for that thing. Not on a very first moment, first second, he decided that I will kill him. No. It happened time after time. Time after time. What happened? When we do not like someone, let's say when we do not like someone, he does something, anything which is disliked for us, we keep that thing in our heart. It is very small, tiny thing in our heart. Let's say, you could name it jealousy, you could name it hatred, you could name it bughz, adawat, kina, anything. Just one dot. But we do not let it go. What we do not let it go. We keep it in our heart and that's start becoming bigger, bigger, and bigger. And after certain time, certain amount of time, after a few days, few months, few years, that thing becomes so bigger, either it becomes easier for us to kill him, or it becomes easier to see him dead. Someone else killed, or you know, he died by his naturally, but nothing happens to in our heart. I've seen this, but my father, my dad actually tells me, I was talking about one person, that Abba, he's such a good guy. I met him today. And I felt that he is a great person. My father, he said, yes, he could be if he is good to you. But let me tell you, when his own brother, when he died, and his janazah was going in front of his house, literally in front of his house. Few people went and he said, look, we know that you had some argument, dispute amongst you. But today he is dead, right? He passed away. So please, let's attend the janazah. My dad said, I'm telling you just because of one thing, you do not make any kind of, you know, thought in your mind, someone is, you know, salih. Someone is very good and you do not share something which is harmful for you. My dad personally told me, when his own brother passed away, janaza was going, and we went and we said, look, your brother passed away, you had a dispute, we understand. But today is, this is the journey, you know, last journey. He's going to Kabristan, let's go and attend his janaza. That person, he told to those who went to, you know, make him understand, he said, so many dogs get killed every single day. So many dogs get killed every single day on the street. I'm not going to attend those dogs' janazah. And when I heard, at that point, you know, it was like grief or something. But today, when I was reading about these things, how come it becomes so easier when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says it became easier for Qabil to kill his own brother? Because he actually did not let that thing go away in his heart. When a very small, tiny dot came, thought, misunderstanding, shak, doubt, my brother is doing it purposely. When small doubt that came, what he did, he kept in his heart. Now whatever he is doing, whatever others are doing, we think they are doing because of me. It happened. I do see every single day. I've heard several times, people do say, my brother, my mother, my mother-in-law, my so-and-so, they are doing only because of me. They have done it only because of me. Even they are not even thinking. They are not even thinking. Because we do create those kind of doubt in our heart. And we always keep it in our heart. And when that thing, you know, we always keep it in our heart, it becomes bigger and bigger. And that can cause a big problem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. All of us. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always tells us, Al-Muslimu akhul Muslim. Muslims are brothers of each other. Brothers of each other. So what are those things if you are brothers or siblings of each other? You do not do few things. لا تناجشوا لا تحاسدوا لا تباغضوا. You do not hate each other. You do not be jealous of each other. You do not fight with each other. You do not say bad words about each other. And if that happens, let's say in case, if that happens, who are the people closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah says, الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ فِي السَّرَّاءِ وَالضَّرَّاءِ وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ. Allah says, Jannat is prepared for few type of people. It is ready. It is ready. أُعِدَّتْ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. Jannat is ready and prepared for few type of people. Who are they? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those who spend their wealth for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even in their hardship. And second, وَالْكَاظِمِينَ الْغَيْظَ, those who control their anger. وَالْعَافِينَ عَنِ النَّاسِ, those who forgive others. Even something bad happened to you, forgive. Do not keep it in your heart. Maybe it's difficult today, tomorrow, day after tomorrow. But do not keep it in your heart. When that happens, inshallah rahman, inshallah rahman, inshallah rahman. If that happens, inshallah, you will see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you before anything else, inshallah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. Anybody who wants, then when he sees Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment, anybody who wants that he should be protected from azab, punishment, anybody who wants that he get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then what he has to do? He has to do few things. Illa man taba wa amana wa amila salihan. Even if we have committed some major sins, Quran says, وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرٍ وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا بِالْحَقِّ وَلَا يَزْنُونَ وَمَنْ يَفْعَلْ ذَلِكَ يَلْقَ أَثَامًا يُضَاعَفْ لَهُ الْعَذَابُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَيَخْلُدْ فِيهِ مُهَانًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, few people are ibadur rahman, slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We, all of us, we claim that we are the slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if Allah says, they are, you are my slave, there's a different story. So Allah says, few people, they are slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And who are they? Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ لَا, it's a big ruku. I want all of you to read Surah Al-Furqan, last two ruku. Surah Al-Furqan, last two ruku. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in one of them, some of the qualities are here. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرٍ. They do not call anyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا يَقْتُلُونَ النَّفْسَ الَّتِي, and they do not kill anyone else. Nobody. وَلَا يَزْنُونَ, they do not commit immodest act, indecent act, zina, lewatan, homosexuality, nothing. They stay away from such action. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, they are the people called ibadur rahman, closer one to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we want to get closer, we have to make sure that we do not have grief in our heart for other Muslim brothers. We do not even think. The sentence, I'll kill you, this sentence is so common. Even in Urdu, even in Hindi, no matter where we are from. Whenever the fight begins, what is the first thing we say? Mari jaan le lunga. Even we do not mean it. Even if we do not mean it, we know we cannot do this. But how come this thing comes in our mind? Comes in our mind. That's, I do see another thing. In today's world, I'm seeing a lot of, you know, youth, youngsters, kids. They play games, right? And in those games, what do you see? What do you notice? What they do? Constantly, they kill people. It's just a game. I'm telling you, it's just a game. But by keep doing again and again, again and again, it comes in our mind, killing someone is not a bad thing. And that's why when anything happens, previously when we were kids, even a dog, an astray dog of the street, if it get hit by any, you know, vehicle or something, we used to feel bad. But today's world, they, when you tell them something happened, an accident occurred, 15 people died, it becomes so normal. So normal. Because in their games, in movies, in TV dramas, shows, it is becoming so normal where they see people are getting killed and we are the one by, you know, playing in the games, we kill our kids. And when in front of them, when you talk, 50 people got killed in Bayt al-Muqaddas in Palestine, nothing happens to in our heart. It doesn't even come in our mind, okay? 50 people, we kill 500 people every day on our TV. Right? It is, I am telling you, it's only my opinion, but it's, I think it's a scheme. It's a scam that, you know, these kids, when they grow, they should not feel such things. They should not. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect entire ummah. Entire ummah. When they keep seeing such things, it becomes normal. It becomes easier to digest such thing. 15 Muslim brothers, 10, 5, they got killed. They just, you know, talk. Nothing happens to their heart because it's so normal. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq that we stay away from major sins. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, last narration, اجتنب السبع الموبقات. Stay away from 7 major sins. As I promise, inshallah, I'll talk about 70. But this narration, Rasulullah himself, he mentioned some of them. قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهُ وَمَا هُنَّ. Rasulullah was asked, what are they? He replied, أَشْرْكُ بِاللَّهِ. أَشْرْكُ بِاللَّهِ. When you do commit shirk, associate someone else with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And second thing, وَالسِّحْرُ. Magic. And I'm telling you, just out of context, this thing came in mind suddenly. With magic, with black magic, we also try to, you know, harm many people, especially where we are from. Many of us in our society, we do see such thing. When two families, they have dispute, argument, and they know that we cannot harm each other, you know, with the hand, physically. So what they do, they go to such babas. You know, those people. And they ask them, this family is not good for us. Do something that they get killed. Do something that they get hurt. And it happens. Because black magic is there. Rasulullah says, As-sihru haqqun, an-nazru haqqun. It happens. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq that we stay away from them. Do not think bad about others. Inshallah, if you will not think bad about others, Allah will protect you. وَمَا هُمْ بِضَارِّينَ بِهِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ Illa bi'idhnillah. And if you will think good, inshallah, nothing can harm you. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give all of us tawfiq that we stay away from, inshallah, Rahman, inshallah. As I said in the beginning of my dars, that we do not kill anyone. We do not. But actually, it's becoming so normal that when others are getting killed, we do not feel it. We do not feel it. And another thing is that, of course, killing someone is a major sin. It's a major sin. But how that happens, it has few stages. It has misunderstanding, shak, doubt, then hasad, bughz, inad, hatred. These are the levels. And we keep, you know, going ahead and ahead. And then at certain level we reach that now it becomes easier for us. Many people, they do kill on the name of, you know, asabiyat, nationalism. Many people, they kill others, you know, on the name of sects, firqas. My very, very close, you know, an alim scholar in India, Sheikh Mawlana Muhammad, Usaidul Haq Muhammad Asim al-Qadri. He is a famous, great alim. In his very young age, he was 34 years old. And he wrote, I think, more than 20 or 20, 21 books. And he is the one in India, he started several things. Several good things as being scholar. He is the one who started like Ittihad. No dispute amongst, you know, ulama, no dispute, no ikhtilaf amongst, you know, groups, firqas. He raised that issue. And he became so famous in very few days. And he was sitting at the mazar of Sayyidina Ghaus-e-Pak radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Baghdad. And you know, some so-called Muslim, they came and started shooting. Literally shooting. 38 people got killed. And Sayyidina Muhammad Usaid al-Haq, one bullet literally reached onto his eyes. And at the age of 34, he got killed. He became shaheed. I cannot blame others that some disbeliever came and did that. When they were killing people, said they were saying Allahu Akbar or something. Literally believers in Iraq. So we do kill people at the name of, you know, firqas, our own opinion. Some people do it on the name of Tawheed. Some people do it on the name of Ahl Bayt. Some people do it on the name of Sahaba. We do it. And that's why everyone else besides this ummah, it becomes so easier for them to hurt our feeling because they know they are not one. They are not one. They are not one. It becomes easier for others. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us. Jazakallahu khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.